Hi, Bonnie, how are you?
Hey, Chance and Dior, how are you guys doing today? Nice to see you.
Good.
Good to see you too.
Fantastic. Yeah, Chance, we've had many opportunities to talk over your career, but this is very exciting because this is chapter three. Like, oh my goodness, this series has just been off
Fabulous.
around. Yeah, it's amazing. It's around forever. So, Dior, I want to ask you, what do you think is the appeal of Are You Afraid of the Dark? Why do kids, why do we all love it so much?
Honestly, you know what I think it is? We always talk about with our showrunner JT Billings about how it was like one of the most edgy shows to come out when it did come out in the 90s. And what we notice with a lot of scary shows that are kind of, I don't know, marketed towards younger audiences is that they water it down. So I think this is a good mix of like truly scary stuff, but also something that won't give you PTSD forever.
Exactly. We don't want that. We want to be a little frightened, but we don't want to be totally freaked out. A chance for you. Tell us a little bit about, set it up for us because this is, a new gang of the Midnight Society. And it's really fun. Like this is my nightmare. Go on a vacation and check into a haunted hotel. I mean, seriously. So set it up for us.
So we got obviously a brand new Midnight Society, and they all band together to decide to go on this beautiful summer vacation. And there's an urban legend that the hotel's haunted. So when they get to the island, they soon have to deal with all of the atrocities that come from that.
Very scary. And dear, tell me a little bit about how you guys bonded. You've got all new gang on the set. What did you do to create that bond between all of you?
Well, honestly, I mean, I'm going to shout out JT so much in this interview, but he personally reached out to every single one of the cast and was like, okay, we need everybody to be involved. And I think we also got blessed with like a really good, like cohesive cast. Like there wasn't drama like ever at all. So we kind of all just banded together to make cast bonding a priority. And like it turned out really well. Like we all still talk to each other 24/7.
That's amazing. And chance for you to be able to give me some good set stories about what you guys did because you're making something that's fun, clearly, but you also have to have that scary element to it. Like, did you play tricks on each other to freak each other out? Got to know the scoop here.
I mean, we were all together for 2 months in a brand new country. So we obviously spending all day, every day together, regardless of if we're working or not, just to, get all close. And I feel like that on camera chemistry is definitely seen because we were all able to get so close, which was amazing. But I don't know if we played pranks on each other to freak each other out, but we definitely joke a lot around with each other and just it was a very comedic set behind the scenes because we're all so close and we were all very affectionate people and we love making jokes with each other.
Well, that's fun. That lightens the mood, of course. There's no question. Now, Dior, I guess I have to ask. I mean, are you a scary girl, type of girl because, or are you afraid of the dark? Like, tell me a little bit about that.
You know what? Chance is gonna have something to say about this one.
Okay.
When we got so I'm very spiritual in my own right, and like I do like a lot of like tarot readings, things like that. And when we first got to the Dominican, I was talking about how some creepy stuff was going on in my hotel, and he was like, "This is all because of you. Like, there's creepy stuff going on in my hotel room too now." So I guess you could say that I'm not afraid of the dark because I cause it, according to Chance.
Ah, okay, Chance. So tell me more about this. And are you superstitious?
I'm not totally superstitious, but I am gonna say that everyone was experiencing weird things in the hotel as soon as we got to the Dominican. And we all blame it on Dior because there was just things that would happen that I couldn't explain. Like my ceiling would start leaking, and it's not like there's anyone above us. We're on the top floor of the hotel. My
Whoa.
doors would like sometimes usually open inwards, but they would open outwards instead. And I'm sure there's a logical explanation for all of it, but it's more fun to just put it on Dior.
Okay, yeah, listen, you got to blame somebody, right? Poor Dior. You got to take it for the team.
Exactly.
When you were kids, like, did you make your parents leave your lights on? Like, were you scared to go to sleep at night, Dior?
Oh yeah, for sure.
Always the lights on all the time.
Yeah. Yeah, it helps. It completely helps. Okay, so Chance, you know, I can't leave this interview without talking about one of my absolutely favorite things, and I've talked to you a million times about it, A Million Little Things. I love that show so much, and you're coming back for season 5. Great little cliffhanger there at the end of season 4. What's in store for Danny Dixon? Come on, we got to get some scoop.
What? I can't exactly tell you what's in store, but I'm going to say that we do start filming pretty soon, and we have a lot of new, crazy, enticing things coming for the new season, so just prepare yourself. Get ready.
Oh, I'm prepared. Like, Gary having a child? Seriously? Come on. Are you ready for that, Uncle Danny?
There's definitely going to be some stuff going on. I can't tell you what, though. I wish I could, believe me.
I know. I'm just teasing you. I just love that show so much. Listen, congratulations to the two of you on the new season of Are You Afraid of the Dark? It's so much fun. Kids are going to love it. And I really appreciate your time today. Thanks so much. Appreciate it.
Thank you.
Okay. Thank you. Okay. Bye, guys.
Have a good morning.
Thanks,
you too.